In the last episode, disaster struck when the rudder snapped and we ran aground and had to be rescued by the lifeboats. In this episode, we start the complete rebuild of Trigger's Broom. The damage to the underside of the boat was extensive, with broken keels and a broken rudder. But with the help of some great friends, this was all repaired and refiberglassed, and the resurrection of Trigger's Broom was underway.
As we sail in to the mystic, hark now, hear sailors cry, smell the sea and touch the sky. Let your soul and spirits fly as we sail in to the mystic. Foghorn blows, I'll be coming home.
Alan.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
When the foghorn blows,
you looking for what?
Dolphins.
Oh, okay.
The new talent I've got.
Yeah.
I have a dolphin features. Already had two pods of dolphins already today.
It's 6 months since Trigger's Broom went rogue and decided to break the anti-terror wall into a nuclear power station. Poignantly, it's Easter, and the resurrection of the Broom is about to happen. I think it's what Jesus would want.
Alan? What are you doing?
Launching the Broom.
Launching the Broom?
Yeah. We're seeking divine inspiration from up above. Adrian, just look.
I'm sure with your
6 months of work and we just got straight under the water.
It's looking good. See some fancy stripes on there?
Yes, I've been very, very big on detail, actually.
You can see.
Some nice little chrome decals going off.
Is that with the hope of being able to go faster?
It's going to go faster because we've got the engine fixed. That'll be a start.
Very good.
To maximise the usable space on Trigger's broom, we had a full camping hood fitted. In addition, we fitted a roller furlex system and new sails. We did extensive work on the inside of the boat to make the boat as comfortable as possible to live aboard. After months of extensive work and repairs, Trigger's broom was now back on its pontoon, looking better than ever.
Alan? Alan?
Yes?
What are you doing?
Doing a bit of an interior revamp on the broom, man.
Okay.
What we've got this week, used to be a boat builder down in Fairley, which is just over there, who used to make boats for kings and queens around the world. Anyway, they're all gathering this week. We've got Mr. Santander's boat here. Got the owner of Fox News's boat here, come from all over the world and gather here. So I thought I'd better tidy the inside of the broom up, put new headlining in and get everything painted up, just in case they want to come aboard. Gotta crack on.
I'll let you get going. Alan?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
Building a boat.
Another boat?
Yeah.
Why?
Boat in a boxes.
I know you wanted a bigger boat, but...
Well, due to our previous history, what we've got now is a nice dinghy paddle ashore on, but it will also double as a life raft.
Good thinking. Yeah, good thinking.
Yeah. Well, how... The only drawback is we only had one size.
Go
it's
on.
Massive.
Go on.
It's bigger than boat. but time passes, get a little outboard on it. Whoa. Spot on.
Very good.
Bit of push, could put that outboard on it. We wouldn't. Probably a bit too powerful. We'll end up pulling wheelies down estuary. But yeah, good, isn't it?
Very good.
Like it. Had to get it because it's got blue on to match the broom.
Then
what we do when we're done with it, basically deflate it, put it back in its bag, strap it to the front of the boat. That's it.
Fab.
great.
Well, what you could do is just...
You've got a seat in it.
You could actually put me in it and tow me along at high speed.
Good. Might do that.
Interesting.
And then cut rope.
Chaos. Thanks.
Right then.
All right then.
Let's have a look at some destructions.
All right.
So that air deck goes into the centre of it. You blow up the outer circle to a certain point. Put the air deck in, blow that up, and then do the hull bit at the end. That's all right. I think even I can do that. Even I can do that. Right.
It's huge.
Loving it. Loving it. Do, 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 do.
All that remained was to come up with a suitable name for the dinghy.
Alan?
Yes, sir.
What are you doing?
We're sailing, Anne. We've got our lovely new sail, working an absolute treat. All colour coordinated, obviously, to the colour scheme. Mm-hmm. For those who are slightly worried about our adventures on the sea, we have absolutely every single navigation and electronic aid known to man for a small boat. Mm-hmm.
And I see an instruction book there.
And trim guide for the sailing, for the various winds. And constantly monitoring the wind direction. Tootling along at a nice couple of knots or so, nice and steady, just with the Genoa out. In the glorious sunshine.
And in the
what more could you want?
In the case of a disaster?
In the case of a disaster, we have Del Boy on hand. Hey! Yes, we're well covered. Yeah.
Very good.
Very peaceful.
Mm. Beautiful. Alan?
Yes, Anne?
What are you doing?
I'm reflecting on the day, actually. Mm,
okay.
We've been out, done some sailing. Got new sails on the Broom. Worked a treat. Done some fishing. Caught loads of fish. A bucket full of fish, actually. You wanted a sun lounging area on the Broom? Voila.
Mm-hmm.
You wanted an alfresco dining area on the Broom? Oh, voila. Mm-hmm. Yeah. We've got an instructor from the Royal Yacht Association coming aboard the Broom on Saturday.
Very good.
So I'm having to get genned up. Survival at sea.
Mm.
Could have written this book. Anyway. Cheers.
Alan, what are you doing?
Just had a very close call with a commercial ferry, Anne. However, we're sailing. Sandwiched between two ferries. Chucked a
about in a little bit of the wake. However, sails are up.
We're doing all right. We're doing all right.
Very good.
Came a bit close, didn't it, that?
A little bit. Alan?
Yeah?
What are you doing?
Finding smugglers, Anne.
Okay.
See that boat over there? Yeah?
Yeah.
It's called Paddix. A-D-I-X. It's owned by a bloke called Jamie Boating.
Okay,
you know what?
What?
It's a wanted map. With Picasso's out of Spain. Down. We're going to make a hasty exit before he sends his lynchmen after us.
Well, I think you better hurry up.
I am. But that's him. Vast world out there, but you can't escape the Broom.
Alan?
Yes, Anne.
What are you doing?
Trying to get us some tea.
What are you hoping to catch?
Tuna. It's not famous round here for tuna, but you never know. I don't think anyone's ever tried for tuna.
What did you catch last time we came fishing?
Jellyfish.
Very good. Let's pray for tuna.
We're having a fishing competition with Willie and his mates over there.
Let's see. I think they might be winning. Alan?
Yes, Anne.
What are you doing?
I'm just having a look at the work we've done in the sleeping area.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think there's a lot more we can do in there. Put all new head lining in, rope edging, black watch curtains all the way around, full bore sleeping area, it's as comfy as. Electric heated blankets underneath, toasty on a night. I don't think there's much more we can do in there.
I don't think so.
Good as we can get it, that.
Mm.
Haven't done a bad job in there, have we?
No, we haven't. It's looking pretty amazing.
Running out of things to do on this boat.
I don't believe that.
Might be time for another. Fancy getting a right old wooden classic boat.
Okay. We'll see.
Doing it all up.
We'll see.
All stained and varnished, immaculate. They're just a nightmare to keep maintaining them, aren't they?
Let's just enjoy this boat first.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh dear.
It's time for a rest.
You're right. You're right. Anyway, not long and I'm in feather. Tired.
Okay.
Good night.
Good night.
All that remains is for us both to say a massive thank you to our friends that's made our dream of a little sailing boat a reality. Without your help, none of this would have been possible. We can't thank you enough. An extra special thank you must go out to our great friends Willie, Margaret, Norrie and Craig for all the help over the last 12 months. Thank you ever so much.
Alan?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
Thinking. You see, the boat addicts out there.
Mm-hmm.
You know he's been dumped for smuggling a Picasso out of Spain?
Really?
And his fines now total about 100 million quid.
Wow.
Because he hadn't paid him. And his prison sentence has now gone up to 3 years because he hasn't served. He's floating about there. The Picasso's on that boat, according to Bob. Still, he can't get anywhere. There's armed guards on it. This is a Picasso on it. Yeah?
Yeah.
The bloke himself's 90 year old. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Do you know this Picasso is smuggled out of Spain? Guess who owned it?
Who?
Him. All they were doing, we wanted to take his own painting to Christie's to auction. So somebody could enjoy it. He's 90, he's had his time with it. Has the world gone mad or what?
Absolutely.
So he's floating about there for the rest of his days, yeah?
With his Picasso.
I think I'm going to met mates with him. What I'm going to do, we're doing a bit of work on boat today. I think I'm going to invite him to the grand opening of the Triggers Broom Cocktail Lounge. Think he'll enjoy that?
Oh, he'll love it.
I'm going to send him an invite by catapult tomorrow.
I hope you got some carver and tapas.
Spanish, innit? He'll be a Rioja man. We'll go to Aldi. That's what we'll do. I think that's a good idea.